When you think of energy, what comes to mind? Maybe a lightning bolt, a battery, or another type of power source. Those are all forms of energy. But did you know that energy is used and produced all around us? Mechanical energy, electric energy, light energy, thermal energy, and sound energy are all part of our daily lives. An easy way to remember this is by using the MELT acronym. Mechanical, electrical, light, thermal, and sound. When you get on a bicycle and push on the pedals, you're creating and using mechanical energy. Energy that is produced by a machine or a moving part is mechanical energy. What does a washing machine, an automobile, a toy car, an escalator have in common? You guessed it. They all create and use mechanical energy to operate. Electrical energy results from the flow of charged particles. Examples of uses of electrical energy are a cell phone, a computer, a light bulb, and a television. All of these use electrical energy to operate. But did you know that a cell phone, a computer, a light bulb, and a television also produce and use light energy? Light energy is electromagnetic energy that can be sensed by our eyes. Whenever light energy enters our eyes, it creates an image. We call this a sense of sight. Some light energy is very powerful, like rays from the sun, a laser, or a welding torch. Here's another interesting fact. Did you know that light energy can also produce thermal energy? Thermal energy is energy that can be measured by a thermometer. When you stand outside and the sun warms your skin, you're experiencing thermal energy. Thermal energy allows for us to warm our homes, cook our food, and even warm our automobiles. Try this. Rub your hands together as fast as you can for 8 seconds. Do you feel the warm up? That's because the friction between your hands converted kinetic energy to thermal energy. Now let's do this. Clap your hands once. Now snap your fingers twice. Which one was louder? The clap is louder because it produced more sound energy. Sound energy is mechanical energy that travels as waves through the air and water. We call these sound waves. When they enter our ears and vibrate in our eardrums, we hear a sound. Whenever you talk with your friends, your mouth and lungs create sound energy that you hear as words. Sound energy can be very strong or very weak. The stronger the sound energy, the louder we hear it. The weaker the sound energy, the softer we hear it. A car horn, a fire alarm, and a speaker are all uses of sound energy. Did you know that there are things that we use every day that use all five of the energies we talked about? A light bulb is an example. When you flick the light switch, you use mechanical energy. Then the electrical energy runs through the wires and reaches a light bulb. When it turns on, light energy is produced, and as it warms up, thermal energy is created. And if you listen really closely, you can even hear the sound of the electrical current in the light bulb. Let's review what we learned. Five common uses of energy around us include mechanical, electrical, light, thermal, and sound. The MELTS acronym can help us remember them. Mechanical energy is produced by a machine or moving parts. Electrical energy is a result of the flow of electrically charged particles. Light energy is electromagnetic energy that can be sensed by our eyes. Thermal energy is energy that can be measured by a thermometer. Sound energy is mechanical energy that travels as waves through air and water and vibrates the eardrum upon contact. And lastly, always remember that energy is all around us and that some devices create all forms of energy when they operate. Until next time.